The Corona Atlas website contains only a relatively small proportion of the available corona imagery. Large areas are not covered, the imagery is not perfectly georeferenced, and sometimes better quality imagery exists for a particular area elsewhere. We are going to download corona imagery from the EarthExplorer website and georeference it manually in QGIS. In your web browser, navigate to the EarthExplorer website. There is a link in the video description. In the top right hand corner, click Login. If you are already registered, then sign in here. If not, you can create an account by clicking this button here. The first thing you'll need to do is to navigate to your area of interest on the map. Once you have found it, click four times on your map to create a rough polygon surrounding your area of interest. If you make a mistake, you can click and drag a point to move it, or you can delete it by clicking the red X in the search panel. Once you're happy with your study area, click Data Sets. The EarthExplorer website contains a vast array of data that we can download, much of which for free, but we're going to download corona data, and this is found under Declassified Data and Declass 1, so tick that. Then select Additional Criteria. Expand Camera Resolution, and from the drop-down menu, select Stereo High. Expand Download Available, and from the drop-down, select Yes, and then click Results. Your results will be listed in the search panel. You can check the coverage of each result by clicking the footprint button. And you can also click the overlay button to examine a preview of the imagery itself. If you want to find out more about a particular image, you can click the Show Metadata and Browse button. This will give you additional information, including the acquisition date, the mission number, and other details. You can also click on the image itself to get a slightly more high resolution preview of it. If you have a lot of images to choose from, two websites can help you decide the best option. The first one is the Wikipedia page for corona imagery, where you can look up the mission number, in this case 1116. And see if there's any notes or details about it. In this case, very successful mission and image quality was good, which suggests that it's a good one to choose. There is a link to this website in the video description. You can do something similar on the USGS website on the corona imagery and other declassified data, where you can look up your mission number. In this case, 1116 is between 1114 and 1117, and have a look at the maximum resolution to see whether it's the best option to choose. Once you are happy with your choice, you can click the Download Options button and then click the download button. As you can see, these are large files, so depending on your internet, this may take some time. Either save your file in a Corona folder in your GIS folder, or once it has completed, move it from your downloads folder into a Corona folder in your GIS folder. The Corona image is downloaded in a .tgz format. This is a bit like a zip file, and we need to extract it in order to be able to use it. To do this, right-click and go to 7-zip and extract here. If you do not have 7-zip as an option, you will need to download it. There is a link in the video description. This will produce a .tar file. Again, this is an archive file, a bit like a zip file, and we need to extract this one too. Right-click it, go to 7-zip, and click Extract here. You will see that this produces 4 different TIFF files. Because Corona films were so long and thin, and they are scanned at such a high resolution, they create very large files, and so they are split into 4 separate files for downloading. It is a good idea to have a look at your files before we georeference them in QGIS, so double-click on the first one. The most important thing is to work out the orientation of the images, because often they come south-north rather than north-south, and so this needs to be corrected. In this case, however, we can see that the images are oriented correctly, because this feature is in the top right-hand corner. If you do need to rotate it, you can click the Rotate button. We are only going to georeference one of these images at a time, so scroll through them and select which one is most applicable to your area. For me, it is image B, so this is the one that I am going to georeference as an example.